If you're constantly worrying about this, worrying about that, how do I look? Is she gonna like me? Do I sound clear or am I loud enough or deep enough for her to want me? You can't do things like that, because when she notices all these things about you, she's gonna throw you away like everybody else that she dealt with and didn't see value in. Whatever else that you take, or whatever thing that makes you not understand why this woman's doing things to you when you are a good man, you take it and you body it and you make it to be something that's going to make you grow, because you can't put up with what you can't handle, and you're going to keep trying to handle it, but you're going to always be shaky with it. My B-Boss baddies and my Batman fellas, it is your girl Bossana, and welcome B-Boss Army. So as you guys can tell by the title, today I'm going to be talking about flaked on a shy beta male because he wasn't strong enough, fit enough, you know, he was shy. I didn't put exact thing because this is going to be actually me making comments about situations that are out here that are real and that are difficult, and giving you guys some advice on what you can do to make this situation work for you. This is a random topic I picked, and if you guys haven't watched my previous video, I was just saying that I'm going to be doing a whole lot of reactions, a whole lot of story times, and things that are back to this topic that I'm doing as well that are going to help you guys out. So I'm going to switch it all up. Okay, so with this whole flaked on a shy beta male because he wasn't good enough, all the comments that I've seen and what I've observed and what I've learned and researched on, it gave me this great topic. And that's why I said in the beginning, I don't know if you want to say good, I don't know if you want to say bad, whatever you want to say, whoever you are still a beta male. And because of that, she flaked on you for those reasons of you being a beta male. And that's what I want to start off with. She did not flake on you because she felt like you were a man, because obviously if you were a man, she wouldn't have never flaked on you. So what does that mean? That means that if you were not showing this beta male side that you actually didn't have, or you do have but you hid it, you would have had such a better chance of her not flaking on you. What happens most times with men and women when you guys are dealing with each other, most times, like I've been saying, you guys are the ones that always approach and make the moves with women. When you are dealing with a woman and you are trying to get a date, trying to go out, trying to come back to her place, trying to get laid, all these things you have to keep in mind. At the end of the day, you being a man, because you have to be the leader, you have to make decisions that's gonna make things keep going, make things keep growing. You guys are dealing with women and actually playing too risky. You guys are literally trying different things that you're not even sure if it's gonna work. And on top of that, you guys are still caught up in your feelings. So when you're dealing with a woman and you still feel like you're at a beta male place, or maybe let's say you don't know, but you don't have success with women at all, you have to literally take in what is the problem. Every time you go and deal with a woman, is it the same thing that you're doing that leads you to not getting that type of woman, getting what you want out of that woman? And if the answer is yes, of course, then it goes back to you being a beta male and a woman flaking on you for these reasons of you being too shy, being too kind, or being a nice guy. Whatever your circumstances are, you have to figure it out. Nobody's really gonna notice it until, you know, you break it down. But at the end of the day, you know yourself, or you should know yourself better than anybody else. When you are dealing with women out here, you're gonna constantly get flaked on. And I'm being real with you guys. You're gonna get flaked on, you're gonna get ignored, you're gonna get ghosted, you're gonna get blocked. Because if you're gonna be the shy beta male, and then on top of that, try to still talk to her because you think you haven't figured it out, but you're still showing that beta male side, she's just gonna keep you to the side, but completely ignore you. And the only time you're ever gonna get noticed again is if you have the money, or you finally stepped into being a real alpha male. So all my beta males out here, let's start off with this. Build your confidence first. My first point right now is build yourself to conquer any weakness you have. All the shyness, being antisocial, and these barriers that basically bring you all the way back, whether it's depression or the things that I mentioned, you have to find a way to build yourself up. You can't try to tackle the world, and obviously it's going to be coming with girls, right? You can't try to tackle that and think it's going to work for you guys if you're constantly worrying about this, worrying about that. How do I look? Is she going to like me? Do I sound clear or am I loud enough or deep enough for her to want me? You can't do things like that. At the end of the day, when she notices all these things about you, she's gonna throw you away like everybody else that she dealt with and didn't see value in. So if you wanna be a valuable man and wanna be that man that she finds like he's the prize, you have to do so much more than the average guy. And that's what alpha males do. The average guy has it packing or has at least some things going on and they know how to treat a woman. Treating a woman like she should be treated is not difficult. And I want you guys to take that right now. You have to treat her how she should be treated. A lot of beta males out here, what you guys are doing so wrong is treating her more than what she's actually valuable for. And what does that mean? She's not valuable for much. All she's valuable for is the body and the image that she presents. So for you guys to take that she shows you guys and you guys feel like it's valuable enough and basically make it to be something, you guys are gonna end up failing at the end. You guys are choosing to give her more based on the value that you think is value, just as much as she thinks is valuable. But guess what? It's only valuable because you two, the beta male and the, let's say, stripper hoe, or let's say, you know, the girl that likes to use men up, whatever terms you want to use, she feels the same way that you feel as a beta male. And that's what I feel like a lot of beta males don't understand. Not only like you guys are nice and all these things, like there's nothing wrong with that, but those things get thrown in because you guys don't know how to use them the right way. So not only are those things, but on top of that, you guys are leveling to the same level as a girl that is for the streets, and you guys don't even realize it. All the beta males and simps out here, you guys are here, and alpha males are here because all you guys do is continue to keep dealing with these types of females. You guys entertain and give up and go ahead and, you know, act like they're deserving of all these things. And then what happens? These females get these things because of these beta males and simp. And unfortunately, it might be you. But you have to understand there is a change for it, whether it's repetitiveness or it's because of the fact that you are not emotionally stable. You have to find something that's going to improve you. And that's what alpha males do. Branch out to things that is going to work for you, whether it's going to be going to the gym. And of course, Corona is going on. So let's say going to, me personally, the stairs. Or it could be you doing workouts at home or going to your local park or going for a run down the street and going back and forth, up and down until you get the results or whatever that you need, right? So whatever it is that is going to be for you guys, as an alpha male, not trying to be a beta male, not trying to be a simp at all, you're going to go ahead and conquer, take over, and build yourself. And it's going to be physically, to your mentality, to your spirituality, to even your religion. I don't really talk about religion, but I'm just going to add into there because I know a good amount are really strong on religion. Mentality is going to be first. I didn't mention it first, but mentality is going to be first because it's going to allow you to be at that place that you want to be as being an alpha male. So let me tell you this, if you can put in your head that you want this new change, that you don't want to be thrown away as a beta male, you don't want to be used up, you don't want to be disrespected or anything like that, you will stand up to the standard of what an alpha male would do. And it's not high. The only difference between you beta males and simp is that you guys don't even try to get to that level. Because once you get to that level, there's so many more levels you have to go up. But if you can just get to that first level of being an alpha male, then you can obviously keep growing. So that means if you're trying to conquer and you're trying to go hard for things, you have to put your all into it as an alpha male would do. But pick what it is that is going to be for you. And as I said in the beginning, whether it's getting bigger physically or it's going to be your spirituality and getting spiritually connected, choose whatever it is that is going to be best for you so you can grow out of being a beta male, being a simp, being a shy guy, and getting thrown away as if you're not valuable. And of course, as I always say, less of a man. You want to deal with women out here? Understand that this is a real world where women will disrespect you. Like, oh, I don't even know what to call them, but they'll disrespect you like you're nothing. Let's say that, right? And as if they are higher and bigger and they're the masculine person in the relationship. I'm getting closer to the end of my video, so I'll say you guys gotta stop, bring your standards low. And if you don't understand what you're doing to bring your standard low, go ahead, like I said, build yourself, and you'll start looking back and reflecting and understanding that that was me at a weak point. And admit to what you are. If you're weak or you don't have it figured out or you have so much to work on, then go ahead and understand that, because most times you can't even get to another level. You can't even be stronger if you're not going to understand what the problem is in the current moment. And so allow yourself to take that in, observe all of it, realize it, analyze yourself. You guys see a guy and say he's this, he's that. Even a woman, you say she's that, she's this. Do the exact same to you. Look at the scenarios that you've been in. Look at the situations that you've been in that made you act a certain way or do certain things. Know who you are. Truthfully, a lot of people don't know who they are, and that's why they're still stuck in this circle, this cycle of going in circles over and over and over again. All you have to do is understand yourself and then do absolutely what you can to get to who you truly are. So to wrap up my video, when I say build yourself to conquer any weakness that you have. As I said in the beginning, whether it's being shy, depressed, or anything along those lines, it can go away or you can work with it. But you, as a man, understand that you are a man. When you're dealing with women, you will take so many L's, or let's say a little bit else. Not everybody goes through the same thing, right? Whatever L's that you take, or whatever thing that makes you not understand why this woman's doing things to you when you are a good man, you take it and you body it and you make it to be something that's going to make you grow, because you can't put up with what you can't handle. And you're going to keep trying to handle it, but you're going to always be shaky with it. Okay, you guys. So I really hope this video helped you guys out. And as I was saying with everything, you being a beta male is not a problem if you don't try to make it work for you or try to get somewhere. The only problem is going to be is if you're not making any progress, whether it's slow or fast progress. If you're not getting anywhere, if you're not growing as a man, then that's when it's really going to be a problem. But if you take L's from a woman, so be it. Remember that. And you guys might not agree, but God is here for you guys, and God is definitely not going to put you in a situation where you can't handle. So that means you go ahead and keep tackling everything that you can so you can get to where you need to be. Okay, and absolutely, you guys should know your purpose in life. Okay, so like I said, I really hope this video helped you guys out, and if it did, please give me a big thumbs up. Please comment down the other types of videos you want to see. Make sure you subscribe with that post notification on and check out everything that is on my screen and yours, of course. You want to see me in my next video. Bye, guys.